Here's your host for tonight, Anna.
When it's like the guy is hosting the end of the season event and, you know, everybody dances afterwards. I'm going to ask you to do that later. Just kidding. But it really actually, like, this is the end of our summer run. It's been amazing. If you were able to catch Tumbleweed, which was our show at 7 o'clock, it was just magical, just so special. So we're really grateful to you for being here this evening. I will not stall things any further because I don't need to. We've got those crazy folks from New York, and that one guy who you really don't want to live across the hall from. Coming up next, it's Seinfeld Unscripted.
Smarter than me.
Do you want a mailbox egg?
Is it hardball? Probably fried.
No,
I just watched it. I have to go with Susan, like.
To get eggs?
Well, maybe. They're shopping. I don't know.
Oh, shopping.
I said yes to shopping, Jerry. I said yes to shopping!
I'll get it. Yes.
It's me.
I've opened the door. Come on in. I'll just leave it open.
It's always open. It's the beauty of it.
Well, it's now it's wide open. Let in air. Airflow. Why is your door wide open? As soon as I heard the buzzer, I opened it up for airflow.
Is it, what's wrong in here?
I was reading an article the other day. I know this is very true, that people are now leaving their windows and their doors open for airflow.
All
right. How are you going to be doing?
Yeah, I am tired. I just ate the largest breakfast. Peterman just took us all out, and my God, I could eat French toast for days, and I think I did.
You had a big breakfast?
Oh, it was so big. There's just like French toast with the syrup, and then they had this berry compote. Oh, Jerry, it was so good. And then there were like these banana praline pancakes that people were sharing. And then there was this omelet that that Peterman had that he let all of us try, and it was just so delicious, and I'm so full. Ugh.
Oh! Jerry, can I use your refrigerator? Lady the Butcher gave me some wildebeest.
Sure.
I got my fridge filled already. But you know, we poached a couple of them, and I got one of them mashed up. So I'm going to put it in here, if that's all right with you, Jerry.
That's fine.
What's going on? What?
Wildebeest?
Yeah, I feel like you're the interesting one in this room right now.
A little wildebeest, you never had it?
No, we have never had wildebeest.
I didn't even know it existed.
Annie told me you take a couple of eggs, you put them inside your mailbox, you crank those things up, take it out of business. Mailbox eggs. Okay? Then you take those and you meet up the wildebeest, and the next thing you got, wildebeest and eggs.
I heard about mailbox eggs.
I'm so hungry!
George, what do you think about the non-fat milk?
It's fine.
All right. Well, there's a lot of milk here. I don't know what type of milk to get. They have soy milk, they have non-fat milk,
no.
They have whole milk.
No.
They have 50% milk.
What's the other 50%?
I don't know. It's not milk.
They never tell you what the other percentage is. They tell you what that percentage is. They never tell you what the other percentage is.
I want to freeze my eggs. I want to freeze my eggs, George. I want to have a baby with you, but I don't know if you're the one after all. So I'm thinking, can I plan ahead and freeze my eggs? And what type of milk is good if I freeze my eggs? Because at one point I'm going to be making milk. So I want to make sure the milk I'm making is as good as the milk I'm drinking. But I don't know what type of milk to get, George.
Chocolate.
What?
It's dessert milk.
I tell you,
what's better than a dessert milk?
I tell you I want to freeze my eggs to potentially have a baby with someone else, and you tell me get chocolate milk? You tell me get chocolate milk? I don't want to treat myself on chocolate milk. I want to treat myself to your love. I don't even know why.
Elaine, I can't believe Peterman took us out to another big breakfast.
Oh my God, I know. Like, what has gotten into him? I like it, but
are you ladies enjoying your breakfast?
Yes.
I hope I'm going to make this a daily thing, actually.
Oh, that sounds lovely.
Yes, I don't think that you're getting enough energy. I, to see more verve from you as a writing catalog cop.
Mr. Peterman,
yes.
I couldn't agree more. Elaine and I were just talking about how she could use more energy.
Oh, I am so tired all the time,
oh,
Mr. Peterman.
My goodness, Elaine, why don't you eat it? In fact, I happen to have a large omelet over here.
Oh, another omelet?
Yes, I'd like to see you eat this entire omelet to make sure that your energy and blood sugar stays up.
Oh, the entire... right now?
I got it just for you, Elaine. Please, you know what? I have a table full of croissants over there.
Oh, I...
Go ahead.
If Elaine is...
You so... both look famished. I remember when I was famished. Traveling the Nile. Carrying a thing to eat. Not even a crocodile egg. Not even a crocodile egg. And yet, because I was enraptured by my own jacket, the leather moccasin jacket that I actually purchased and bought for that trip. Yes?
You know.
What?
Mr. Peterman.
Please tell me.
I'm still just so full from the delicious breakfast
we
had this morning.
Oh, my goodness. Look here. I can see you turning white and sheet white right before me. The white that I turned when I was bitten by a tsetse fly. My goodness. Elaine, you eat and eat. Yeah. I don't want you to see another croissant left over there. Ladies, eat. I have to go attend to something else.
It's kind of a lot of pressure. It's a lot of croissants.
All right.
This is the alley where I met the mole people.
We have to stay on task. We need to find a mailbox we can use. I need to be right about this.
Well, it's a good thing we're going after Long Island. They got a bunch of them out there.
A metal one. It will heat up, and then we can cook the eggs.
That's right. You know, the last one, the wooden one, lit on fire. The little red cardinal thing that went up and down. Like a tree.
It's a crime. It's a crime. It's mail. That's the tampering with mail.
I never get any mail.
You don't get mail?
No.
Since when?
Since I swear my loyalty to the mole people. There I was in the alley. I said, Kramer, would you like to join the mole people? I said, why not?
No. That just seems like a postal issue.
What?
It seems like a postal issue.
I'll talk to Newman about it.
Switched to neutral.
Jerry, what are you doing?
I switched to neutral. I've always wanted to switch to neutral.
It's the most underused gear.
That's what I thought. It feels fun.
All day.
Why not? You've had all day.
Jerry didn't have any eggs.
Jerry only keeps expired cereal in that apartment. I am so...
Cereal doesn't expire.
Yes.
Have you seen an expired cereal?
Yes, I have. In your cabinet, yes.
Yes.
Well, I'm still alive.
Expired food doesn't kill you. It's just disgusting.
And why expire?
It's just take. It's hard. See, this is the thing with expiration. If it's hard, it gets soft. If it's soft, it gets hard.
Yes, that. It gets stale. Stale cereal is expired cereal.
What's wrong with you?
I'm on probation.
Says who?
Newman. Yeah.
Mail probation?
Yeah. They put me on mail probation.
What does that even mean?
That means that I can't get any mail. I have to go to the actual place to get the mail.
Like your stuff?
Your mailbox is on probation?
Yeah.
How did that happen?
I've been using it to cook with all kinds of things.
Your mailbox inside your apartment.
Exactly.
Finding a separate mailbox.
Well, I wouldn't want to.
You're in on this?
I wanted to see
You're doing all the cooking?
Heard the little lady wants us to freeze her eggs.
I don't want to talk about it!
Wait, what? Susan wants to freeze her eggs?
Yeah, evidently, now George isn't good enough.
Future George has potential.
You better lay off the burgers. I heard that meat destroys the semen. That's why I eat the exotic meats.
So do hot tubs.
You gotta get some of the wildebeest.
I don't know.
You don't know.
Grandma! All right, look at you. All right. Easy!
How do they get the frozen egg?
All right.
What, am I a doctor?
I thought maybe she brought it.
No, she just landed right in the milk aisle.
Yeah.
Well, all I was thinking about was how good chocolate milk is. Then you know.
That's where you went wrong.
Eggs, frozen eggs, future George. Frankie George isn't happy!
Hello, Jerry.
Hello.
Hello, what?
Sir?
I'm gonna pretend I didn't hear that. You know, Seinfeld, it gives me the greatest pleasure in the world to give you this.
Money?
This may...
I don't have my readers on. That I just got.
This may be a green slip of paper, Seinfeld, but don't play coy. I, Newman, hereby give you this. Male probation! Oh, yes, you are! We have cameras all around the city, Seinfeld. Just because Kramer's a friend of mine doesn't mean he's exempt from male probation. And I think you two are in cahoots. Putting eggs in mailboxes. How sacrilegious!
Science! For science! I've never thought about science.
I'm more of a religious man myself.
But maybe they could be both things. The science.
Will you sit down?
Looking for good magazines. I don't see
any.
They're all old. They're all expired.
Why does this matter? Magazines can't go stale.
I break them.
Sorry, the magazines aren't up to your liking. We get that complaint all the time.
See?
All the time. I'm just going to go over some things on your chart here. It seems something we don't usually see.
Good thing.
Detected a very rare protein. I'm not sure how it would have possibly gotten into your cells, but you haven't eaten any wildebeest recently. Either of you?
What have you been feeding me? What have you been feeding me, George?
Stew.
Okay. You have your moment. It's a whole thing. Wildebeest, this protein will just eat up the eggs and they're like 50% good. They're freezing right now. But, you know, change your diet and come back in again. Good luck.
Guess we're back to now, George.
An entire room full of food is waiting from some of the most exotic places. You know what I got hold of recently? Wildebeest.
No.
I shot it myself when I was hunting in the upper Mozambique.
Mr. Peterman,
we can't eat more big bread.
My God, it's happened. You both have lost energy.
No. Mr. Peterman, please, this is the only outfit that fits me anymore.
Well, there's a plenty of the back room. We have plenty of Jane Peterman stuff in the cabinet.
I know. I cannot.
Is this a religious thing? Are you fasting to try to indulge the spiritual aspect of your life? I remember I did the same thing back when I was...
Hello and welcome to the Audi!
See, you know, people don't understand you. I do.
People don't understand us. What have you brought us? We're hungry.
We are so famished.
We're so hungry. What have you made us? What have you brought us?
Hey, easy, easy, easy. I brought something. I left in the car.
The car?
Yeah. I borrowed Jerry's car.
Jerry's?
He's coming.
Jerry's car!
He doesn't believe you're...
Jerry's car!
All right, easy, easy, easy. All right, be good. Hey, Jerry.
You took my car?
Oh, I thought you were in it.
Who's that?
This is Jerry.
Jerry's car!
I thought you could do a fast two for him.
A fast two.
Yeah, they wanted something. I don't remember the two. That's
fast
what I
two in an alley? I don't even know these people.
That's all the better.
We want fast stew.
A fast stew?
Make us a quick stew. The quickest of stews.
The quickest of stews.
The quickest of stews. The quickest of stews. The quickest of stews. The quickest of stews.
You guys need a present.
Ooh. Will we end?
Me? No, it's not.
All right, Mr. Paper.
Wildebeest?
Yes?
Yeah, right. Making the little boys swim.
We cannot accept your donation.
Come on. Come on, take it. Take it. I want to help. I want to help the human race.
I think you've helped enough.
Okay. All right. So, how about a date?
This is very unorthodox, Mr. Kramer.
All right. You know, there's no worry. You know, what do you think? I mean, you're
quite fine. I think you've done enough, Mr. Kramer.
Okay.
Yep.
Six.
Okay, no, forget that.
All right. Yeah, come on. I need more of that wildebeest. Come on. Kicked out of the mole people. They kicked me out. They said I wasn't quality mole.
That put on mole probation?
Yeah.
Said, we will charge you anyway. And I paid it and have not forgiven them. I am now boycotting Uber. Please, everybody, do that.
I have one clarified question before we ask more. Mm-hmm. In your villain origin story, if you had to identify one person, as the person who wronged you, which of those characters is it the friend, the representative, or the driver that you would say is the person that wronged you?
It was the driver because my friend could not help her bodily function, and the Uber representative I don't think was a real person.
Okay. Your friend, how did you meet them? Who are they to you? Are you still friends today?
Yeah, we're still friends. She's actually an improv friend.
I was like, she
knows that, like, this story has been told and she's laughed about it. So she's an improv friend, we're still friends.
Is she gonna pay you back?
She did.
Oh, okay.
She is fine and she's a good friend.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, a good friend or not, baby. I didn't grow up.
Were y'all like celebrating anything that made her get this drunk?
Yeah, it was like a holiday party.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Which holiday?
This is where you get judged.
It was a Halloween party.
Yeah, there it is. All right, let's give a round of applause for Nikki.
Uber guys, we have a very weird.
I brought my own car.
Right. There... Yeah, I don't know. You guys are called, but.
Y'all, we are worried too much about the godliness of all of us Uber gods.
We all have titles. What are you talking about? We just not all Uber gods.
You have the Prius god.
Yeah. Oh, what?
Yeah, yes. I'm a Mercedes god.
Yeah.
I'm the Jeep Wrangler nymph god. And you're standing in my doorway.
I'm going to put this case down. Yeah. I got to look through my book, my orientation, because I did not get...
You didn't get a god name?
I didn't get a specific
vehicle.
You didn't get a god name?
Guys,
if
you don't apply for a god name within 12 hours, you don't get one.
I didn't write the manual. I read it, though.
I didn't write or read the manual.
Clearly. I mean, and then you got this job as an Uber god. Wow.
You're taking way too much time. My battery's running low.
There's charges. There's like quick charge stations everywhere. You'll be okay.
My Jeep runs on masculinity.
I think I found it. Okay, if you should be assigned and requested assigned an Uber specific type of vehicle to God,
yes.
Within 12 hours, you do not.
Yes.
Then you get assigned to 1983 Toyota Corolla.
That's just the rules, okay?
Honestly, I'm fine with that, because there's not a lot of Ubers that qualify as 1983 Toyota Corollas. I've been thinking I had a lot of free time, but this is nice.
You have a lot of free time now.
What?
Oh, I'm just saying, I mean, okay.
We can't just be like, oh, we're all moving to Uber Black and you're staying on Uber X. I'm sorry.
I
mean,
after this, we were
gonna let him sit in his Corolla for a little bit. And get,
I'm sorry.
There's some really pristine 1983 Toyota Corollas, you guys.
Yeah. Actually, if you pull the book back up, it has to be a post 2000 car because of emissions.
Yeah.
Those are all words that are important to Uber.
This is where we draw the line. This emissions?
Yeah.
Exactly.
No, there has to be a grandfather clause in here somewhere.
You can keep looking, but it's not. And we're gonna go to Uber Black.
Yeah. What am I supposed to do?
We've
been training for Halloween since Memorial Day. the Constitution still this week? Do you know how much I've been drinking since Memorial Day?
I know this is important. I know I messed up Memorial Day.
And that was fine, because it's just Memorial Day. It's just the unofficial start to the summer. This is Halloween. This is the officially unofficial end start to the fall.
Almost had something here.
I forgot about Labor Day. Yep. Which is the unofficial end of the summer, and then we just kind of have a weird month and a half.
You're making me nauseous. I feel for Tyrone.
The Trulies are getting to me, and I'm making beer, and this Pikachu onesie is hot.
That is a fire-ass outfit, though.
It is.
Literally and figuratively.
Well, it's figuratively a lightning-ass outfit. If
one little speck of saliva comes out your mouth, this will be the end of it. We will do a couple's costume without you.
It's a lot easier to have a couple's costume than a drunkle's costume. This kind of is actually beneficial.
I will be the Pokeball, and he will be the Pokemaster. Oh,
just choose me, y'all.
I can hold it. I'm good. I'm fine. We're just gonna go ahead and we're gonna do bobbing for apples.
Can you do that right now?
Yeah!
Okay, all right.
I think you should go last.
No, I
don't. He said he's ready. He's ready to
pop it. I can do it.
You know, depending on how this goes, I will not bob for an apple after.
I need to dip my face in water anyway.
There you go, buddy. Get it all out.
I got an apple.
Yes. Tiger, hey.
Me? Wait, I'm sorry, I didn't know.
Yes. I'm the office popular girl. And you're new to the office, so I'm so excited to have you here today. And the office.
Oh, before I say something. Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Okay. My name's Sabrina.
Awesome.
Yes.
That's a beautiful name.
Yes.
Oh my God, I love Sabrina.
It's American.
Oh, okay. I love American names. So yeah. Girl, I just really love to just bring in the new girls and teach them how the office runs.
You're trying to teach me.
Yeah. I'm so excited to have you here.
Could you first explain what we do?
Yeah. Actually, process complaints for Uber.
Okay.
Yes. We just press the button and it just answers it for us. But we have to be here to do that because machines really can't work on their own.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Machine once and like it didn't work.
Yeah. So you never answer the phone, you never say anything directly to the customer,
okay.
You just press the button and the machine will talk to the customer.
Okay,
okay.
I'm gonna try it out
because
I get it.
Yeah, I know you do, Sabrina.
Yeah,
American name Sabrina.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, you got a complaint, Sabrina.
Okay, and I just press the button.
Don't say anything.
Okay, but what if they are holding back our policies?
That you just press the button.
It says they're threatening legal action. I just feel like...
Just press the button.
Is anyone there? Is anyone there? I'm honest, we talk like a real person.
Okay. No matter how much they scream or cry or beg, you
oh
just
my
have
God.
To just okay. press the button.
But the button just says thank you.
It'll say... Coding.
Yeah.
Or Sabrina. Sabrina is typing. That's what it's going to say.
I don't like typing. I just want to. It feels like he really needs help.
Sabrina, yes. Help me, please.
That's his personal
my name, which
problem.
Is like.
Yeah. Yeah. Just keep pressing the button. It's okay.
Thank you.
Exactly.
Oh, did I satisfy your concern today?
Exactly. You're doing so good, Sabrina.
I still can't find my wallet.
He lost his wallet.
Wow.
Can we just call the
driver
upset.
Hi.
Hi.
It's so cool to be the cool guy in the office.
Oh my god, I'm a cool girl.
I noticed you.
Oh my god, did you really?
You seem so cool.
I am very cool. Everybody loves me. I teach you how to push buttons.
That's so cool.
It's fantastic.
Sometimes I push the buttons and then it like says I'm typing, but I'm not.
You're such a bad boy. You're cool and you're a bad boy.
That's what makes me cool. It's because I'm a rebel.
Yeah. What other rules do you not follow?
Like sometimes they say you can only take a 15-minute break.
Uh-huh.
I take a 16-minute
break. Oh my god. What other rules do you break?
Like sometimes they say, like, don't heat up fish. Uh-huh. It's usually like flounder.
Oh my god.
I'm just taking before pictures, you guys. It helps. They say you should always do it before, like, anything.
Anything. If we end up on CNN, at least we had these before.
We'll have so many before pictures. I've even taken selfies. Sometimes it's harder with my own hands. This is a Kodak disposable.
Thank you for the clarification, because that was a bit lost.
But you can't really see if you're taking a picture of yourself.
Right.
True.
Yeah, it's 1998, and this is a one-hour Photoshop, and I'm just producing pictures that you put out, and it's just a lot of pictures of hair.
It's really hard to get the angle right because you're holding what I believe to be a camera upright. Like this, what I believe is a button.
Yeah.
It's just like you can't, you know, and so it's just, I was hoping one would just take my passport photo.
Yeah, this one has red eyes and the lighting is terrible. I wish you could see these things, but apparently you can.
I just need one that says, I'm American.
Okay.
If any of them works.
Yeah, this one looks pretty good. You look like
you're... That's my dog.
Okay, this one is fantastic. This one looks like you're an American. You have a beer and a flag and things that American people like, so it looks pretty good.
No, that's ICE undercover. I was catching them across the street.
Oh! Yes.
This isn't our
family. Leroy, I lost the photos. Okay, so when we go to grandma's house, you're gonna give it to her and you're gonna say, look at my kindergarten photo.
You guys are holding up the line. I just gotta check your passports and you can go. You got the mom.
Your passport photos had to match the photos of grandma, or grandma's gonna be suspicious.
They're gonna take me to the back again.
Go ahead, Simon.
Hey, I'm Simon.
Yeah, this looks like a black person.
I'm 27.
Oh my god, when I saw you, you were just here.
I was two.
Okay.
You know, I keep getting fired for doing too much, and I just.
Who is firing my baby? Do I need to go down to the office, girl?
There's this office popular girl who's just in there. She's just like, oh, you know, like your name's American, but you're not cool. And she's like, don't work with the customers, you know?
Oh gosh, I wish I could confront her, but I'm the same person, so I can't.
A lot of songs from like the 60s and 70s, like really like poppin' dancey music. I remember not mostly the songs, but like the feel of the jukebox and like sitting and listening to adult conversation. But
did you ever overhear anything that later on you're like, oh.
Not that I can recall, but I remember my grandparents arguing with the manager of the bar because they would bring me in. So that was conversations would get pretty heated, but like I didn't know what they were talking about.
Because you were not supposed to.
Because I was not supposed to be there. Yeah.
Other than going to dive bars, is there one other memory you can share about your grandmother?
Yes. So she liked to take walks at night. They live in Annapolis on the water, so I really liked doing that with her. So we would go and we'd go hang out on the pier, and she's always talked to me like kind of like an adult. So we just have like long conversations, and I'm sure I'm talking nonsense, but like, she invested time with me. Like, yeah.
Does she ever give you a piece of advice?
It's mostly about dating.
Tell us.
She's still of the school of thought, like, I just need to marry rich and that'll fix everything. So she didn't, but grandpa does pretty well. But yeah, so that's most of her advice is like, yeah, just find, doesn't matter what he looks like. Doesn't matter if he's like a great person, you know. He has money, so you'll be okay.
And any advice on how to find them?
What to do. She can do what she wants.
That
2023, am I right?
You are right about the year. Okay, well, let's do this away. Let's start this date again. My name is Cassie, and I am charmed to meet you. And I'm wondering how much... I don't know what that was.
I'm sorry. God.
Okay.
We're a big high five family.
Yeah.
I'm William.
It's so nice
William
to...
William Kennedy. we're Irish from the County Cork.
The Massachusetts Kennedys, the ones who are.
I'm not thinking the genealogy.
No. I am sorry. I do want to get to know you as a person.
I want to get to know you.
Great, but I've been told I need to marry someone rich. And this is...
Rich in spirit?
No.
I'm home. Grandpa dropped me off just a few minutes ago. Oh boy, I had a lot of fun.
Hey,
babe.
Yeah.
You had fun?
Welcome home.
Hi.
Welcome home.
Thanks.
We're so glad you're back like 45 minutes early.
Yeah. No, I...
You aren't doing anything.
Not a damn thing.
Nope.
Well, I had a great time with
Grandpa. I was doing something.
I was
some of us weren't doing something.
Welcome home.
Are you under something? Your hair's messy.
Oh, I was just laying on my pillow.
Yeah, sure was.
And there are so many interesting people there. Like, I learned all kinds of new words. Like, shit.
Did the bar close early? Because I just thought you were gonna come back at 4.
Because bars typically close early.
Yeah. Well, after that, we went to Grandpa's house where he was meeting with his buddies, and we played, poker?
We also played poker.
Why are you doing that? You're making faces and you're saying things in a weird way.
Wait, what do you mean?
This is the way Grandpa talks when he goes in the back room and then he comes out and he acts funny.
Your dad is getting laid in bars?
Yeah.
Sorry, but you cannot play your one-man band in here. This is a fine dining establishment.
I'm dressed like this. What am I supposed to do?
You can wear it. You just can't put it to use. This is where nice people come to eat nice food. Look at these nice people.
You didn't say this when you booked me. I'm contractually obligated to play my knee cymbals and my tambourine hat.
Yeah, when we booked the Colin Douglas Experience, we thought you were gonna play the piano or something. I didn't realize you were gonna show up all percussive.
One instrument doesn't sound much like an experience.
Sorry.
Let me prove it to you. Let me give these lovely guests of your place the experience that they deserve.
You got one shot.
That's all I need.
I sure hope so.
One shot. I'm on my sweater already.
Yes!
bothering you?
No, he honestly looks like a really, really, really kind person. He's just like, honestly, he looks like someone who's probably gonna be like very influential one day.
I personally would love to hear the rest of this song.
That is so nice of you to give him the space.
Give him the space! Yeah.
I've been told if you eat your food while I'm playing, it tastes better.
Mmm.
I didn't think that this caviar lollipop could taste better.
Yeah. This lollipop steak is so good.
Right. Lollipop away.
Whole song.
The whole song.
Should be anywhere. I don't know. I'm 6 years old. I just swam an impossible distance.
sorry you had to hear that.
Sorry, is she single?
Feels like we've gone a long time without deciding what we're going to do with this underrepresented minor. I know I'm a company, but he's also
I'm also underrepresented. There are no minors in the scene.
Yeah.
There are not! It is a very isolating experience.
I bet. I hear you and I see you.
Thank you. Yeah.
Well, did you left? I mean, while we're here, I've never really left of Maryland, so do you have anything that you maybe want to say about like what the big world is like out there?
The string suddenly pulls up.
Oh my god, a grown man!
And just prior to this moment, we see him in Seattle, and there's a red line down Seattle, down the coast of California, through Tijuana, down through the Panama Canal.
What's going on with the Panama Canal?
Look, it's an underrepresented man.
I was here with you the whole time. I even sent a narrator to accompany you.
That was you?
Yes, that was me. I just wanted to make sure you were okay.
I felt so abandoned.
I would never abandon you.
I know that now.
I think they know each other.
Well, darn, I was hoping maybe we could have a kid.
Yeah. We already renamed him.
Oh.
I forgot my old name.
And now it's just Parker.
Well, now that you're a man, you can choose your own path.
And just like that, the tide comes in and and the red line is running and it goes all the way down past Florida to the Panama Canal, which is empty at the moment. Very fortuitous. Up through California. Past Seattle and all the way to the San Juan Islands, which are an island off the coast of Seattle.
Hey, you're showing it off, map lady.
Right? Yes.
always find us on Facebook, on Instagram. Trying to think what else I need to be telling you. You can donate. Come on, yeah, if you like it. Fun. Yeah. And that's, I'm going to leave it there. Let's, before we welcome them on, we're just going to, like, do it. Come on.
Such
new storyline.
Just, oh, it's amazing.
Yeah.
You look original.
Thanks, yeah. It's my first time seeing you. Avengers. Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah, right?
Is it like a DC thing or something?
every time, there's a couple.
We're actually not together.
Not yet. We know. We're still in the trailer, so you can chat it up now, but like when the movie starts.
Shh.
No, you can't.
Shh.
Have you guys seen the Ohio Mansion?
Amazing.
I love Eddie Murphy. This movie's kind of boring.
Just keep it calm. Just stay calm.
I bet you in the end I win.
I can't reduce Marvel to winning and losing. That's just, that doesn't make sense.
Are you guys mind keeping it down?
That's fair.
I heard that the Iron Man dies.
He should take. I take medicine for iron.
Yeah. Especially women, they need it. You need it if you don't have enough iron. I think he died from that.
I have anemia. Am I gonna die?
No. You're friends with me.
I don't really get that.
This is cooking over here.
I feel you guys getting married soon.
Truth teller. With no chins in your pocket.
I don't get it. Hey, do you guys mind if I scoot down? I like close to the screen.
We do mind.
I love the little more movie seats.
Every time I come to one of these, I see it as a hallowed experience.
You guys mind if I sit in this chair? It's closer than the other chair.
It's very annoying.
Your breath is terrible.
You smell like Listerine.
You mind actually if I sit here? Thank you so much.
I actually will. Sure.
This is the best. Are you guys my parents?
Doctor, I really can't see.
Okay. Got a little something squirt in there, did you?
Neither confirm nor deny.
You're acting like I asked a sexual question.
No, I think it just may be my cataracts or something.
Okay, so not a lemon pepper squeeze, not a marinade, not a tapenade, not a margarita bit, just sizzle in your eyes, nothing like that.
It could be anything.
It
could be anything.
Oh, it could. All right, because we got to narrow it down. I'm going to need your help.
Doctor, there's something.
In the keister or in this?
It's just, I can't tell.
This meeting.
It could be lemon pepper.
Doctor, I feel like there's something just there. It could be anything.
Stay with me.
Okay.
I had crawfish recently.
Because we're a bet.
Oh.
Hello. All right. You got this?
I got it.
All right. She's got the floor.
Okay. I'm sensing tension. No tension here.
No.
We're one team.
Oh. We just need
everyone. I just heard y'all.
y'all arguing before this, so then y'all trying to act cool.
No, 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 no. The kids will not split the prompt.
Okay.
No.
No. I mean,
we're just trying, we were just animated about what superhero prayer will say.
Oh, okay.
You wanted to start one, baby bunny?
Yes,
I love, we know all the prayers that she knows.
Yeah.
So. Everyone, we'll step out. Just the talent.
Squeeze it, please. Okay.
If y'all do fight, I am on his team, rather than her team. Just want you to know that.
One team here, please work.
If we could all grab our tails.
I am Groot.
Oh yeah.
And let's be honest, we all know the prayer together. I think we can say it together.
Oh, yeah.
No, of course. Absolutely.
Okay.
Ha ha ha!
Oh my gosh!
Oh no! It's like a little lobster!
It is. Well, please enjoy our farm to table dinner!
Plus B squared equals C squared.
I mean, it's Anita.
Anita?
Yeah.
Anita Rollins?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. With the beautiful ponytail?
I had my long curly hair then.
You thought you were from the West, and every now and then you'd go, yeah!
I still do that sometimes.
When?
Oh, I mean, like the yeehaw?
But yeah.
Oh, the, well, like yesterday. I did a yeehaw.
Go ahead.
Yeehaw!
Anyway.
So, Father Pete. So I went to a doctor and lied about my condition.
Ooh.
Yeah. And I said things were squirting.
I don't get it.
I said that things had, like, liquid had just, like, been placed on me.
Yeah.
But.
Oh! Oh! Oh.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Like immaculate.
Yes. Yes. Immaculate.
Yeah.
Pete, this feels weird.
Yeah.
You know,
I know.
Like, we should be, like, I want to. Oh. Pete.
Good to see you.
Yeah, I know.
Hello, my son.
Bless me, Father, for I have sinned.
Yes. Yes, you have.
Pete, is that you?
It's me. Who's that?
Greg Jennings.
Greg?
Yeah.
Greg Jennings, all-star quarterback.
Yeah.
Fairview High School.
Yeah, dated your sister for about 8 weeks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, I went to Fairview High School, too.
Hey, are you guys making cutbacks? Are you doing multiple confessions at once?
Yeah, hold on 1 second. Hello, my daughter.
I'm Jewish, no thanks.
We're in the wrong place, but you're always welcome here. That's a kneeler, by the way.
Oh, welcome.
Oh, hi.
I didn't know there was other Jews here.
Yeah. Just, you know, a nice escape, you know.
Yeah, it's great to see people in the church again. Jews, Christians, Muslims. Yeah, it's just...
Everybody's welcome in Father Pete's church.
Yeah, it's just great to see the pews full again. Yes. Not a lot of people know what's going on.
Hey, could you guys keep it down until I pray?
Of course.
Father Pete, Dr. Castrense, I'm back.
Oh, welcome back.
Yeah.
What ails you, my child?
Someone may have floated this way and mentioned something about some wetness.
I got a couple of those. A couple of squirts here and there.
Dr. Pete.
I'm a doctor of philosophy and religion. I went to divinity school. And I did dabble in gynecology.
Yes. I learned everything I know from you. I don't think you'll be surprised to know I've been the one making all of these people squirt.
Oh, my precious baby, what you gonna be when you grow up?
Be a gynecologist priest.
Hello.
Oh, this hurts so much.
I thought you lathered up.
Oh, she lathered up. We de-lathered her. You know when you count on that friend to be the responsible one to bring the thing?
I get it, but I mean, I understand.
She didn't bring the thing.
But you were all on her.
We tried.
Okay, well, guess who just lathered herself up in banana boat green aloe gel? Just for you.
All right? So everyone go ahead and dance around the pole. I need you up front a little bit more.
Okay.
Wait, you're going too fast.
The bottoms of my feet are still.
The tops of mine.
Stay here.
Where's she going?
So identical to me.
Kill the
weird about it, to be honest.
I'm weird too.
No, I meant you're weird. I'm not weird.
Oh yeah, you're weird. Yeah, you're weird.
Okay, what happens if we get married?
We have little
keep everything going and work behind the scenes.